knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
After examining many different species within the genus Homo, we arrive finally at modern humans, or Homo sapiens. This is the only surviving hominin today, the last of a long lineage. According to genetics, Homo sapiens emerged as a species in Africa some 300,000 years ago, while other hominins were excelling in other areas of the world. This origin is supported by both genetics and paleontological work. Genetically, an African origin of Homo sapiens finds support in the modern phylogeny of humans, where non-African genetic diversity nests within African diversity. This diversity disparity also indicates a migration out of Africa with several founder effects. Linkage disequilibrium is also higher outside of Africa as compared to inside the continent, and the highest levels of heterozygosity are also found within Africa as opposed to elsewhere. Mirroring this genetic support, the oldest Homo sapiens fossils are found in Morocco at a site known as Jebel Irhoud and dated to approximately 300,000 years of age. Identifying Homo sapiens within the fossil record can be difficult, as there are few characteristics that Homo sapiens has to the exclusion of other hominins. However, three characteristics that are commonly used to identify the species are the presence of a chin, or the osteological structure described as a shelf on the mandible, a vaulted forehead, and a globular brain case. These morphological characteristics reflect a further shrinking of the dentition and a growth of the brain in very specific ways, namely the swelling of the frontal lobe. Homo sapiens of Jebel Irhoud are primitive. They have the sloping brain case and enormous brow ridges reminiscent of earlier Homo erectus. However, their faces appear much more familiar, and the shape of the brain case is argued to be just a touch more globular than other hominins. Lithics at the site indicate advanced tool use on par with what Neanderthals were doing to the north at this time, but these hominins are definitively not Neanderthals. Around 100,000 years later, at a site called Omo Kibish in Ethiopia, we find Homo sapiens again. This time we see the characteristic globular skull shape, although the brow ridges are still a bit large, alongside the first human chin. Around this same time, a similar skull, Apodema 1, can be found in southern Greece at Apodema Cave. This hominin provides support for the notion that Homo sapiens attempted to leave Africa around 210,000 years ago, but failed. This is evidenced by a slightly younger skull, Apodema 2, which belongs to a Neanderthal. Perhaps a plucky group of Homo sapiens were chased out by a better prepared group of Neanderthals. It isn't until approximately 70,000 years ago that Homo sapiens leaves Africa, carrying a characteristic morphology. By 50,000 years ago, Homo sapiens are in Australia. By 45,000 years ago, we are in Eurasia, and just 5,000 years later, Neanderthals disappear. By 15 to 20,000 years ago, Homo sapiens is in the New World, spreading across North and South America like wildfire. All along the way, we are innovating. Tools of all sorts allow us to make long and short-range weapons, usable on wild game and perhaps each other. Fire is at our fingertips, allowing us to exploit myriad resources we wouldn't otherwise be able to exploit, cooking meat, greens, nuts, and more. We heal our sick, protecting them and our vulnerable young in larger groups instead of small families. We definitively make art, crafting literal and symbolic pieces alike. But of course, Neanderthals did much of this as well, so why are we here and they are not? Some have proposed that Homo sapiens actively killed off all Neanderthals and Denisovans, while others proposed we entirely subsumed them into us by interbreeding. The truth may have more to do with chance and a bit of selection. A recent paper has proposed that the secret may be in one point mutation responsible for increasing neuronal density, one lysine to arginine mutation found in modern humans, to the exclusion of archaic humans and Neanderthals, may be the key, as it tripled the radial glial cells in some population of up-and-coming Homo sapiens. This mutation, alone or perhaps in tandem with others, may have made Homo sapiens a bit more innovative, a bit more cognitive, and perhaps a bit more adaptable to change. As the climate was shifting, perhaps Homo sapiens was able to shift with it and outcompete everyone else, leaving the other hominins to go extinct. Homo sapiens, with our globular skulls, vaulted foreheads, and chins, managed to outlast every other hominin and spread across the world. Around 12,000 years ago, we built the first megalithic structure, Göbekli Tepe, while we were still hunter-gatherers. From there, and likely at numerous other unknown places across the globe, Homo sapiens society would become human civilization. And because we have now reached Homo sapiens, the species that we are, we necessarily conclude our study of biological anthropology. Let's continue chronologically and begin to examine archaeology next, so we can see what happened as Homo sapiens truly began to flourish.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.